Gott, I suck at cutting. Nö, ihr seht es. Hello, fellow gamers and crafters. Tokrak here with another episode. I just watched the Black Magic Craft video where he's building a cage for his D&D campaign and gets really annoyed about it, trying to build it, because he tries to glue it together and nothing really sticks. I want to show you the solution, how I'm going to build a cage. And I have to admit it, it's cheating. It's like cheating to the highest level, because I'm going to build a cage practically in 1 second. I'm going to show you. Here's my cage. Okay. You already see it's a full cage. Almost. I'm gonna pimp it up, but to explain to you what it really is. It's from the supermarket. It holds a fruit called Physalis. I hope you can find it in your spot. Otherwise, just go to the fruit section of your supermarket. Right now it's winter and they try to sell all these berries for super high prices in the tiniest amounts. And if you check it out, some of the packaging might be similar to something like this. I got mine like half a year ago, and I think by now they in the EU they somehow switched to paper, but if you're lucky you might still find some of these. Okay, I'm gonna pimp them and see you in the end cut. It's always a bit tricky to know in advance what I will need for the craft, but I guess I have figured it out. So I have these cages, they're from the cheapest plastic. I have to clean them up a little bit here. I have a little bit of XPS leftover pieces. These were from my door projects, the inner part, maybe you can see it. Some super glue, but I'm not sure if I'm gonna use super glue or hot glue, I have to decide yet. Some skewers, wood ones. Mine are a little bit thicker. Crafting knife, pliers, and potentially some green stuff. You don't need all of this, you can make a simple version, but I'm trying to make them real fancy. So step number one is to first clean off the extra plastic that is still on the pieces. Do it slowly, don't cut yourself, and don't accidentally slip and rip through your cage. The center piece that you see here, I will leave it on because I have a plan on what to do with that. When you touch the material, you can also feel that it's very slick. So before I'm doing anything extra with it, I'm going to give it a nice wash with soap. In the next step, I'm just going to use one of these wood skewers. I roughly estimate a length that I want to have, as it's good enough for me, and then I'm gonna clip it off. And then I'm gonna clip all of them to the same length. Yeah, and then comes the tricky part, how to get the skewers onto the frame. I tried everything. I tried crafting glue, I tried super glue, I tried plastic glue. And the thing that I found was working best was just a good old hot glue. So I decided to go with the hot glue. And I'm gluing all the wood skewers into the corners of the cage. I want my cages to have some doors, so I'm just going to use this leftover XPS pieces. It is slightly thicker than my small finger, which is still too fat for me, so I'm trying to cut it in the middle. And here you can see my incredible cutting skills, because I can't get a straight cut. And so yeah, just try until you have something you're happy with. And from these doors, I just want to keep the frame, so I put them on top of each other and slowly cut my way through it. To glue on the door frame, I'm going to use the hot glue again. I measured it before and I'm just going to use some tiny dots on the inside to hold the door frame. Then I turn it around and apply some more hot glue from the outside. Careful not to use too much hot glue because it can melt the foam. I press the second door frame on it and then I'm almost done.
I wanted my doors to have a lock on them. At first I thought I'm going to do it with green stuff, but then I just used the leftover XPS pieces, cut a little square out of it, and used a needle and my crafting knife to form the keyhole. And then I glued this one on, and my doors had a lock. I'm happy. Then it's time to cover up the plastic square that is full of plastic at the top of my cage. And I'm going to use some green stuff, which is a two-part resin. No, not resin, sorry, epoxy. And I'm going to mix it up, and I form a handle, because I want my cages to look as if they can be lifted if you have a crane or something like this. First I thought it's going to be real tricky to get the green stuff on, but actually it sticks like crazy to the plastic. In the end I got some butter on my finger to smooth it out, and that was it. Then I went outside and primed everything in white, because I thought it would make the follow-up colors look better, but honestly I could have also done it in black. I think it would have been easier in retrospective. I tried to match the painting scheme from Blackmagicraft, so I'm using some non-metallic metal color. This is silver, and I used a little bit of black with it because I didn't want to have it too shiny, and I used a little sponge to apply it all around the cage. I had some spots that were a little bit hard to hit with a sponge, so I also used the brush. The XPS didn't take the priming very well with the white color, it almost took none of it, and it also was a bit harder to paint it than with the silver, and so I just gave it like a really thick coat of color. To achieve this rusty look, I did practically exactly the same that Blackmagicraft did. I used a light brown, which is here burnt sienna, and a bright orange, which is vermilion red. Then I mix it 50-50, take it with a sponge, and I dry the sponge on a piece of kitchen paper, and then I basically, it's like a dry brushing on the cage that I do. I go relatively easy on it, and I keep repeating it until I get the look that I want. And I must say, I was honestly surprised by how good the rust looks on it. Unfortunately, one of my skewers came off, but I just glued it back on with some hot glue. And here they are, some menacing looking cages. They can hold around 9 minis, and I would say fairly easy to craft.
So I want to thank Blackmagicraft for inspiring me to finish my cage project that I hadn't touched in half a year. And there are two things that I want you to take away from this video. First, have a look out for materials you can do your crafts with. Almost everything can be turned into something crafted one way or the other. The second thing is, sometimes you start off a project with the utterly wrong material, and that makes things infinitely more complicated. So if that happens to you, maybe take a step back, reconsider the materials you're using, see if you can find somebody doing it differently and get inspiration from that. If you did craft a cage for yourself, leave a comment down below telling us what you used for your cage. That's it for this week. I want to thank all the new subscribers, and I would say now it's your turn to craft.